Hey folks, today I'm going to be showing you how to use the Smart Albums feature that comes with your Mac to very quickly and efficiently organize your photos. Coming up next on Tech Talk America. Today's class is brought to you by socialprintstudio.com. I have personally used these guys to print out many of my photos, and I would never recommend them if I wasn't thoroughly impressed with the final product. If you want to check them out, there's a coupon code that you can use to save off your first order. You'll find that code in the description of the video. Now, onto the class. Usually when I'm working with my clients and helping them organize their photos, the first place we really like to start is by creating a simple folder structure so that we have a place to save all of what we're about to create into. So let's open up the Photos app, and as you will see here, clearly it has recently been Halloween here in Provincetown, Massachusetts, which is where I live and record all of this stuff. If you ever want to see a very, very unique music video, all choreographed to Britney Spears' Toxic, you can find it in a link in the description of the video. All right, let's go over creating that folder structure. So if you're kind of new to this stuff, the first thing I would recommend that you do is go over here into File and go to the third item down, which is a new folder. Now, of course, you can organize your photos however you like, but the method that I have found seems to work really well for a lot of people is to organize them by year. So for now, let's work with 2018. Right now, we're at the tail end of it, as I've already mentioned. So let's just call it that. The next thing that we're going to do is we're going to create a smart album that goes inside that folder. So with that folder highlighted, we're going to go here to the top again, and we're going to create a new smart album. I'm going to start with creating a very, very simple one that I think you will really like. So we're going to start by just taking all of the photos that were taken in this particular year, and we're going to put them inside of this smart album with one little caveat. So you can see here, I've named the Smart Album 2018. And then over here, we have a whole bunch of different options that we can choose from. So over the course of this video, I'm going to show you a couple of those different combinations of folder types that I think will really help you organize your photos. So let's start with going here into Date Captured. This is a very simple one. Change it from Is to Is in the Range, and then just make it January 1st of that particular year until December 31st of that particular year. Now, before you hit OK, there's one additional feature you might want to consider adding to this. In addition to knowing what photos we have snapped in a particular year, there is also value in knowing which of those photos have not already been organized into albums. So what you might want to consider doing is hitting the little plus symbol here and adding a second condition. So because we want it to match both conditions, up here you'll notice this has just appeared. So now it's saying we can either have it match any of the following conditions or all. And for this particular combination, we're going to do all. So now let's change this down here to album is not any. So what this is telling us is we're going to create a smart album that is showing us every photo that is taken in a particular year. And then on top of that, we also want it to ignore photos that are already organized into albums. Now, because we're brand new here, that number has not changed. But as we go through and process these images, it will. So now that I have created my smart album, you'll notice that it is located inside of my 2018 folder. Now let's double click on this image to go inside of that smart album. Now from here, what we're going to do is we're going to very rapidly process these images and get them organized into corresponding albums. Now from here, you are going to need to know how to select multiple items, which is kind of a Mac basic. So basically the two ways that you can do it are either holding the command key and individually selecting photos, or if you're going to do a group of them, like I'm about to, let's start with these drone shots of the day's cottages in Truro, Massachusetts. We're going to click on the first item, hold the shift key, and click on the last one. So from here, we're going to tell the computer to organize this into an album. And depending on which version of Mac OS you're running, and ultimately which version of the Photos app you are running, there are different ways to do this. But the way that I believe works universally for everyone is once you have your photos selected, then you can go and hit Command N, which will place them automatically into, if you look here on the left-hand side, an album. Now, it is going to automatically name that album the same thing as my corresponding smart album. So now we just have to type over it and rename it. So let's just call this Turo Drone Shots. And what you'll notice is when I lock it in and then go back to my 2018 album, all of those images are gone because of that second condition that we created. Only show me photos that are not organized. So as you can see here, you can very quickly go through here. Let's do one more together. So let's take all of these Halloween shots. And I'm telling you folks, you gotta see this video. It's amazing. So click on the first one in your list, hold down the shift key, click on the last one, hit Command N to create a new album, and then just rename it. The next type of smart album that I want to show you how to create is one that is specifically looking for files that have a similar name to them. So let's say I want to look in this case, for demonstration purposes, let's say I want to find all of my various drone shots. Okay, whenever I'm taking a photo with my drone, the actual file name typically has the first couple of letters in common. This is also the case with a lot of digital cameras. So really all you need to know is what are those common letters that would be found in the name of the actual file. So in my case, my DJI Mavic Air always makes the first few letters of every photo DJI. So I want to create a smart album. Let's do that right now. And I'm just going to call it DJI. And now instead of saying photo, we're going to change it to file name. So in my case, I'm going to type DJI. Okay, and you can see here it found five photos that match that. Now, if I wanted to also include photos maybe from an older drone of mine, again, all I would need to do is add the plus symbol and also say, okay, also if the file name includes one of my old drones, this is a unique drone, spelled very weird spelling, Y-U-N-E-E-C. I think, I don't know, that weird, those weird spelling companies. Anyways, so I want to say in this case, match any of the following conditions because I do want both of them. So now let's hit OK. And there you go. There's all my drone shots from two different drones, at least the ones that I have on this particular demo account. So you can see how very easily you could recreate that same recipe with photos of yours that maybe had been scanned in. They're going to have those very, very similar file names. Just use that same trick and it should help you out. Now, once again, from here, what I would probably end up doing is processing these photos. That's if you want to be able to have access to them on mobile. The next type of smart album that we're going to be creating is one based on relationships. So who is actually in the photo? Now, before I show you how to create this, I just have to at least mention that this will only work if you have actually taken the time to go through and identify who the people are in your photos. If you haven't already done so, there's facial recognition technology built into photos. However, you do have to have taken time to identify who people are. So if I go up here to the people tab right here, you can see, for example, if I use myself, I can just double click on myself and I'll see every photo that I'm in. But when you want to find other people, that's where this smart album is going to be really, really handy. So let's go to file and create a new smart album. And I want it to show me every photo that has my mother and I in it, just for this demo purpose. So let's call it mother and son. And instead of photo, we're going to change that to person. For this, we're just going to use is, and then I'm going to just simply select her in it. Now, if I want to also include myself, which is really not necessary in this case, I could just hit the plus button, also add a second person, and then put me. If I really wanted it just to be the two of us, I would need to make this all. And as you can see here, yes, that is one photo in this particular case. This next trick won't work for everyone. It partially depends on how you ultimately got the photos in your computer. But if you are trying to find all of the older pictures that you have and group them all together, one of the things that all of those are going to share in common is that unless you've added it manually, none of them are going to be tagged with GPS. So another useful combination that you might find is this. Photo is not tagged with GPS. Now, these can also include photos that you were emailed, or if somehow the GPS location information was stripped out of the photo, but for some people out there, this is still going to be pretty handy. For those of you out there who use more professional equipment, another handy feature you might want to find is to create a smart album that only shows you photos that are shot in camera raw format. Of course, camera raw shots do take up a lot more space, and professional photographers, this is going to be a really handy smart album. The final type of smart album that I want to show you how to create today is one for a reoccurring date. So let's say, for example, that you're a parent and you have kids who dress up for Halloween every year. If you want to create a smart album for Halloween, you could have it automatically show you what they looked like on that date every single year. So for this particular example, let's use Halloween since that's what I've got here on my screen. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to make this date captured is, and then I will just simply type in on my keyboard to correct the date, and then hit the plus symbol. So for those of you who want to make this happen every single year, you would just need to add this and just go back in time as far back as you wish it to go. And then make sure that up here it says match any, because you do want to see all of them. And then when you're done, hit OK. And then you'll see the photos captured on that date from as many years as you tell it. That trick is also really great for birthdays and anniversaries too. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this class. If you did, I really do appreciate it if you hit the little thumbs up like button. Leave me a comment down below. If you haven't already done so, I hope you'll consider subscribing to my YouTube channel, and I'll see you next time. This is David A. Cox with Tech Talk America. Class dismissed.